So just again, good morning to all of you. So just recapitulating what we have discussed yesterday, the disease scenario, the level of diagnosis, how there is a biotic factors and abiotic factors that are responsible in whole disease. And if you look into the scenario, Indian scenario, maybe it's a totally different types of disease pattern occurs in whole of the country. Maybe region wise, type of culture practice, water body type. Maybe if you'll go to Andhra Pradesh, if you'll stay for a period of 1 month or 2 months, you will find all type of disease pattern that are occurring because the type of cultures that has been done there, that is a intensifications and culture practices you find, and the productivity they manage. And you will find it's a great way that will be responsible for understanding the disease process. Again, it will come down like your traditional fish culture systems, like your West Bengal, Bihar, or Odisha. The pattern of disease is coming down, maybe less occurrence. Again, if we'll go to again the northern states like UP and other parts, again the different types of scenario. So just like a whole country looking into a particular type of disease pattern that may occur in a different types, you cannot assume that a simple disease may occur. But today, if you say some of the parasitic disease, maybe they across the India, it is more prevalent. It is more prevalent than that of any other things. So in general, we'll talk some of this, like if we'll see how disease pattern occurs and types of disease, because yesterday I have shown some of the clinical signs and symptoms that are responsible to understand the disease pattern. Then if you look into the systems like your, how it can be have a synergy that are coming into a disease pattern, that will help you for understanding the disease mechanisms that are responsible in the whole country. So how you can see this whole disease pattern in the country, that will be helpful for the disease pattern of this country, and we'll discuss one by one the disease systems that are responsible when we coming into the some of the disease that mostly if you look into the bacterial disease or something that will just hold sometimes I can share some of the screen to all of you.
At the bottom there is icon the screen sharing.
That was there, but when it is going, so the file is not coming. I am trying with it. The file is not coming. That's only butter. I am putting shares because when it's on drop, it's quite good. It's not on that from the desktop.
Yes, okay, no, come.
It's not coming somewhere. 8 minutes. अरे प्रतीक, वो जो शेयर स्क्रीन के बाद वो जो पावर कर दी माइक्रोबियल डिजीजेस, ऑल ऑफ यू नो मोस्टली इन इंडियन सिस्टम्स लाइक योर ग्राम नेगेटिव बैक्टीरिया एंड फ्यू ग्राम पॉजिटिव बैक्टीरिया दैट एनकाउंटर द सीवियर लॉस इनटू द सिस्टम्स. Maybe you will find in the whole of the Andhra Pradesh, they call it a red disease. Maybe the farmers call it a red disease. Maybe thinking that whether type of bacteria or anything, a different type of bacteria that cause the disease in a symptom like red hemorrhages or something, ulcers or large wounds, they named it a red disease. But this red disease may be due to maybe a group of Aeromonas or Pseudomonas or somewhere maybe ETAD also cause, but they distinguish the rare disease like this. Again, there is a columnaris disease. They also name as a columnaris disease. But if we'll see a science point of view, the mostly if we'll see they are the gram negative bacteria, few gram positive bacteria. Today coming like your staphylococcus or streptococcus, they are causing diseases. So if you look into this, like your first, I have given the a columnaris disease. If we will see columnaris disease, maybe there is a flavobacterium columnare. But today, if we will see last year, we find search the columnaris occurrences whole of the India. We don't find a columnaris pattern that are occurring in Indian conditions. So we try to develop something, but there is a group called cryobacterium group. Means these are the columnaris like bacteria, the cryobacterium group. Are mostly predominant, that are finding the symptoms of the columnaris. But when you go for isolation and identifications, we don't find a flavobacterium columnare. Again, there is a, so this columnaris disease mostly if we'll find maybe associated with the gill and external lesions. If we'll find the gills or external lesions or operculum, maybe a diffuse scattered hemorrhages that occurs. Diffuse scattered hemorrhages that occurs in the system and that is responsible for the disease pattern. So if you look into this type of columnaris disease, maybe in 2005-06, maybe whole of Andhra Pradesh, maybe 400 crores loss occurred that time because they got a large intensive stocking practices and it was widespread in the whole of the water bodies in the Andhra Pradesh. So that is a type of system, but gradually this disease pattern has come down. And whole of the India last year, we sent a scholar, one or two scholar in the surveillance. Hardly we find, means not 2 years, last 2-3 years, the occurrence of the columnaris disease is very less. So again, this is a, and if we'll find, because I have given one photograph here to see, only if we'll see the ventral side of this near to your snout and other things, there the diffuse hemorrhages portions are located. but there is a diffuse pattern, and if you see in the silver carp also, it causes a large wound also, circular wound in the operculum aspects also. So these are the symptoms of a disease, of a farmer point of view. Then again, if you go for the isolation and identification studies, the basic gram stainings and other properties coming into this, then we will see the individual bacterial later stage, how it looks, the staining, and what are the difference between the physicochemical and biochemical parameters, maybe biochemical parameters, catalyze or catalyze test, other test that is responsible for them. But again, if you see, again is another flower bacterium group. Earlier, this was sometimes called the flexivector also, flexivector columnar. So another group also called the bacterial gill disease. That is your flower bacterium branchiophyllum. Flavobacterium branchiophyllum, if you see, mostly it is gill is affected. So that is a, and so because of branchiophyllum, it is called because it is affected with the branchial regions, means your gill regions. Then third is, if you see, then maybe a pseudomonasis is mostly caused, maybe there may be three groups of bacteria, maybe pseudomonas aeruginosa, pseudomonas fluorescens, pseudomonas putida. These three group bacteria sometimes called pathogenesis, and fluorescence is sometimes, you see, like your, it is a large number of hemorrhagic spots, and sometimes you confuse with by the some of the fungal granulomatous conditions. You will see the blood is oozing out. You will say, and this is a mostly predominant phenomenon in the maybe some ornamental fishes. Most occurred this type of disease, but in carp and other things, it is less occurred phenomenon. Again, all of you know that aeromonas group, aeromonas species, which belongs to an enterobacteriaceae family. Aeromonas species is mostly predominant, maybe aeromonas hydrophila, aeromonas cavia, aeromonas veroni. So these type, so many group are now is a disease causing pathogens in case of fish. And maybe 10 to 12% of the mortality is caused by due to aeromonas species in the Indian culture practices. So yesterday I was talking that from spawn to fingerlings, maybe 12.5%, and in different culture systems how it varies. So if you have a management measures, and if you take the type of the environmental quality, so you can reduce these infections. Besides, you may use some of this standard sanitation and phytosanitation measures to check this disease into the aquaculture industry. Because as all of you know, feed is the major component in aquaculture systems. In, even if you look into the freshwater aquaculture, only feed contributes maybe 70% of the expenditure cost, and 30% is oil. Again, it will go today, the culture practices, the demand even feed, we do not go up to pellet feed also. Most of the Andhra-based cultural system use the DoL feed, even if many of the cultures in the other parts do not use feed also. They believe that maybe nature has God-gifted some feed to fish to grow. But that is an extension system. But in the disease pattern from extensive to intensive systems, if you are going to the feed-based system, DoL-based systems, maybe a lot of feed waste in the bottom that leads to the organic portions enrichment, again the multiplication of these pathogenic organisms, and aeromonas is out of this one of the pathogens, and mostly predominated in the Indian conditions. Again, these aeromonas species maybe will go to the most of the warm water climates. It is found maybe a disease condition. So if you go to the cold water and certain parts of the northeast, you will find less conditions. Again, if you go to the another pathogens like I told you, Edwards cillosis, the disease is known as the Edwards cillosis, and this caused by the Edwardsilla tarda, E. tarda. And Edwardsilla tarda, and if you will see, this is a pathogen also in few carp situation, but it is more pathogens in catfishes and catfishes. Then this is a, again, this slender rod, and it is just like initially the Edwardsilla and Aeromonas, you will see it will go for catalase or cytochrome oxidase. Pteromonas is believed to be cytochrome oxidase positive, and yeast ada is taken as the cytochrome oxidase negative. So, and both if will go to the isolation study in RAS medium, that is Imlers and Schatz medium, or Aeromonas isolation medium, in particular in RAS medium, both of them grow. But if we'll see Aeromonas hydrophila is a yellow pinhead colonies, but yeast ada is a yellow colony with a black center. Yellow colony with a black center. So this is a typical, maybe a morphological distinguish between the two species. When you somebody go for the RAS plate isolation for the identification of these two bacteria between them. Again, another way we mostly go for the presentation, when any catfish got infected, we try to put in the same RAS medium, thinking that it will be a black colony, it will allow with a black centered colony to come. So this is the two means distinguished characters that you can identify between these two species. Again, if we'll see a lot of today, because if we'll see maybe catfish was not practiced widely in our country for the culture. As the cage culture is introduced in the systems and the Pangasiodon hypothalamus is an alternate species to the cage culture. And if we'll see our carius batrachus is a low fecundity and it is a slow growing catfish. Still people like to culture besides also heteronostis facilis. Again, Ompok Pabda is coming into a because it is a high value species. If we'll see look into the other part like Mr. Singhala or large catfish in Bihar, large of wetland that your that is a large catfish that bowl you told in your local name. So these species, if will go to the domestications or the practice, you may find this disease caused by to the Edwardsilla may be a rampant is origin with which a havoc to the industry. Because we do not practice more of the culture practices in the systems, hardly we encounter less. But if you will see, there is another name of this Edwardsilla tada, another species that is Edwardsilla ictaluri, that cause a large disease in the channel catfishes. And if you will see in the American countries, so that will be more prominent for the Edwardsilla ictaluri infections into the ictalurus punctatus also. So these are the some of these, if you see, look into the system where you can find this type of large culture practices that are encountered. And again, Vibrio. Vibrio I mentioned because Vibrio is less frequently encountered in freshwater. But if you are going to the freshwater prawn culture, that Macrobacterium rosenbergi and Macrobacterium malcolmsoni, you will find the Vibrio is also one of the important species for the freshwater prawn infections also. Because the Vibrio, the again, leaving the Vibrio angularum, which is caused disease, angula initially, it was isolated from angula in the Western countries. So this angularum is less occurred in Indian conditions, but it is also disease causing problem. But if you see, there are 28 species of Vibrio, starting from Vibrio, Algemalaticus, Paramelitus, Harbi, Fluvialis, so on. And these Vibrios are mostly acute pathogens to the shrimp industry. The shrimp industry sometimes collapse like luminescent Vibrio, Vibrio and other things. And today if you'll see like your Kanagawa stain of all these things, Vibrio is more problematic in the shrimp industry. Again, I have put some of this, like if you go, maybe the different treatment. These are the, if you'll see the phenotype characteristics, the disease occurring, causing bacterial pathogens, then we should, knowing to this, the causative organisms, maybe if we go for a farmer point of view. A farmer asks you how to treat, what will be your strategy? Again, it comes for a student or researcher point of view, or if you have a point of view, go for a diagnostics, a vaccine. So three approaches you go. If a farmer's point of view, he wanted that immediate relief of this. So therefore, how you will place immediate relief of this? Then you have to do something good thing. that you should have a treatment strategy for the farmer point of view. Then how you will do for advice to the farmer? First you see, suppose if you will go to the aromonas and other things, that is maybe initially, all of you heard about this CIFRAX? Yes or no? Or US epigeotic ulcerative syndrome disease? Any of you heard about US epigeotic ulcerative syndrome? Yes. Hello? You heard, because you see, all of you know or a few do not know. You see, why I am pointing here in the bacterial disease portion, if you see, maybe the in 1980s or 90s, late 90s, early 90s, US come into the Indian subcontinent from Australia, through Tripura state.
Actually, sir, okay, there is a problem. Sir, actually, there is a problem. They didn't go through with the finfish and shellfish disease yet. Because, okay. Yes, sir.
Okay, these are which year class student?
Sir, they are second year students, sir.
Okay, second year student. Okay, yes. Let me tell you. So, if it's a disease, and that US epigeotic ulcerative syndrome, it comes from Australia to India via Tripura state. That time, if you see R.J. Robert, is a renowned pathologist. They have FAO-TCP program studied. And in addition to, if you see SIFA, Dr. Mukherjee, Dr. R.K. De, Dr. V.K. Mishra, then here Dr. Manas Das, these groups that time, they have started studying the what is the causative agent of US. So a lot of, initially the Robert group has opened that it is a rhabdovirus group. Okay, it is a viral etiology. Then Indian groups come out, it is a bacterial association of the Aeromonas hydrophila. So later on the research comes again, there is another C.B. Mohan Shankar group with another foreign counterpart. Then they have studied, then it is, they told it is a produce a mycotic granulomatous condition. Mycotic granulomatous condition. Then they define the US either epigeotic ulcerative syndrome is the necessity cause of DJ aphanomatous invadrans, which causes mycotic granulomatous condition. So the definition of US is turned and it was defined as a causative agent is a aphanomatous invadrans. It is a fungus. But initially it was Aeromonas hydrophila associated. And based on that, Dr. S.C. Mukherjee and their group at CIFA, they developed a medicine that is called CIFAX. And that CIFAX is mostly controlled the US of these things. So that time still it is in the market, they apply the US. So why I named here, if you are going to red type of disease you find, so US, then CIFAX can be used for the controlling of this US. How you will use, that is maybe, it is used is 1 liter for 1 hectare meter water depth. 1 liter for 1 hectare meter water depth. You have to forecast it. How again, 1 liter forecast means you may divide into maybe 100 liter. You put 1 liter into 100 liter. 1 liter into 100 liter. Then gradually take 10 liters and forecast in the water body, may be used in a bucket, but it, because there is iodine derivatives present in this, so generally when you are putting your hand, you should wear a gloves, or you can wrap with a polythene, then with a mug and bucket, you can spread over the whole water bodies, so that you will find that the healing process starts. Maybe the healing process experiment done, carried out by Dr. Gadadhar Das, a professor of West Bengal of University and Fisher Science, how the healing takes place, gradually the blackening, the reddening becomes blackening and becomes a healthy one. So why I am telling, this CIFAX can be used for the bacterial infections, to combating the bacterial infections also. Besides, I told maybe a pond treatment of sometimes used. Generally, all of you have seen, if you have not seen, any netting operation done in a pond, so when they release the fish or when a crowding takes place, and everybody put a potash solution. In a potash solution, which is a perfect disinfectant. So therefore, I mentioned here, it may be pond treatment of potassium permanganate rate of 5 ppm will reduce the infection rates. Then maybe sometimes now oxytetracycline or tetracycline is a US FDA approved drugs used in aquaculture. Sometimes we can use 70 to 80 milligram per kg body weight of fish for 7 to 10 days. Then it, you will find the disease comes down. Maybe sometimes you have a limited number of fish that are coming. You wanted to say something?
Yes, sir. Sir, what is the active ingredient of CIFAC, sir?
So, you see, I cannot speak because those are inventor and has not disclosed till now. Okay.
Yes.
That is that. So, it is mentioned CIFAC. They have commercializing every time. So, it is only those are selling and those are inventors. They know what are the active. You know, this started with 7 lakhs. Now, it is in the market for 2 crore something for 7 years. So this way, the end uses and all these things. So gradually, these are growing up. So I don't know exactly what is the active ingredients. But as per the knowledge of the things, this is working. Again, if you see, sometimes if you have one, two or few species got infected, so you can go for a bath treatment of this. Bath treatment of some of this. Maybe like table salt, sodium chloride, sometimes you can heal up, or sometimes the copper sulfate also. They both use for antifungal or maybe antimicrobial agents also. So again, if we'll see today, I can scale down the cost also. Sometimes I use betadine, the human that you use betadine lotion for your body or some injury. I always use. Because I can say 300 ml if you use betadine per acre hectare meter water depth also, the cost is 300 rupees. Then you can heal up this type of bacteria. So I always advise also, if nothing is available, go to a medical shop, get a betadine of 300 to 400 ml per hectare meter water depth. And it's only 300 to 400 rupees. You can heal up this type of diseases also. So these are the, in general, the bacterial diseases in fin fishes that are encountered in Indian context. I have mentioned a few of you so that in the beginners, you can understand. Then suppose these are the, again, some of these bacterial diseases you could see, maybe from tilapia to different fish species, there are the bacterial diseases that are encountered, you can see, based on the clinical signs and symptoms here. Again, if you look into these things, then I told, I have studied because my last 20 years of experience on the disease. So I have the Indian scenario, how this disease pattern that are occurred in team. If you see, there may be, or if you see Southern India and Eastern India, maybe my most of the research is concentrated at this part of the India. So you see how this disease of different I have given in the below, from Aeromonas hydrophila, Vibrio species, Pseudomonas, Flavobacterium, Edwardsilla, Staphylococcus, then Acinetobacter baumannii. So these are the pattern. Today also we found some Klebsiella pneumonia. Also this is a human pathogens. Then Acinetobacter pitti and Acinetobacter baumannii. So these are also some of the new emerging bacteria that are coming into these systems. Besides your, like your Aeromonas baroni, Aeromonas johnsoni. So these are the new pathogens that are encountered. In the last 2-3 years, you are finding some of the new pathogens, bacterial pathogens that are encountered into the disease of Indian aquaculture systems. Again, you see, the state-wise, you will see Andhra Pradesh and Odisha, and these are the things, Karnataka. So how this in a map scenario, you will see, the mostly the bacterial disease are spreading in this. Again, we do not find more in the northern part because maybe colder climate and people do not go for that much practice. Again, if the water bodies type of culture patterns, so when you go for intensification, or maybe the northeast is, again, the northeast portion is few bacteria is found, because maybe not to be well studied, the culture practices, the availability of integrating the practice into the systems. So therefore, we do not find lot of aquaculture activity some part where they do not encounter the disease scenario. Again, if we'll see, I am continuing the bacterial disease with some, you see, in some photographs here, like if we'll see, that is a bacterial ulcer. How it does it looks in the tip of the snout. Again, if we'll see fin rot and peduncle disease, some of these fish species. This is the rotting of the fin. Maybe this is mostly the Pseudomonas group. Again, there is another disease conditions that is called a dropsy. What is meant by dropsy? Dropsy means, just like, have you heard few years back, maybe 2-3 years back, when the mustard oil is called the dropsy conditions in the human being? Have you heard or not?
Yes, sir.
Maybe 2-3 years back, so people ban off taking mustard oil, other things. So dropsy is a condition, is a bulging of abdomen. Bulging of abdomens, and the scales erosion takes place. If you take a pen and put a reverse side on the scale, you will find scales are coming out. And you press the vent, you will find edematous fluid is coming out. So that is called a condition of dropsy. So this condition occurs, maybe if you'll see in the aquaculture pond, maybe 0.1 to 1% populations is a dropsy conditions. And again, the bottom fishes, bottom of the fish, bottom dwelling fishes, migals and other things, that are mostly affected. Because of, if you'll see, maybe there is a bottom, maybe if you'll see a very old pond where your humic acid is more, bottom sediment is more, so you are unable to clean up all these things, there you will find this type of condition will be occurring. Again, also sometimes maybe some pond is a newly constructed pond, water level is getting down, so less water depth, there you can find also this type of conditions. Again, what is the causative agent? Maybe you will find, so there may be three types of phenomena is believed due to causative. Maybe some of the toxic gases liberated due to old ponds that cause the conditions. And second one is a nutrient sampled, maybe some of the contaminated food or mycotoxins, other things, or bacterial infected that cause to these conditions. Third one is maybe a combination of these, maybe bottom gases and the microbials. So in the isolation process, some of the main Aeromonas and Pseudomonas groups of bacteria also involved in this dropsy process. So then what is the healing process? You should not worry, because of maybe 0.1 to 1% population is getting affected. So it will not affect the 100% of the population, but you want to change the management strategy, feeding strategy, then improvement of the water qualities. So if you look into these husbandry practices, gradually you can control this type of disease in your aquaculture process. Right? It's okay. Maybe you are second year, maybe so when going for one of the disease process, I am explaining, but I am showing some of the phenotypic characteristic of disease so that you should have the idea about the whole of the disease process. Again, you look into this. So I told, I have shown you a photograph. So here you have a gill is not there, but flower bacterium, this is a branchiophyllum infections. You see how gills are being separated and the blood has been gradually reduced and they are fragmented. And this type of, if you see any pictures of the gill, you can definitely tell that this is a bacteria caused by the flower bacterium group, maybe branchiophyllum, or sometimes also columnaris also associated with this. So this is a clear pictures. I have taken this picture in 2006 while working in Andhra Pradesh also. Again, with this, anyway, because that time lot of laws were there. So I was monitoring this and we were dissecting some of the fish. You see the internal anatomy of the fish when that is infection takes place. The diffuse of nest, again, if you go to the heart also, we have taken there is a, you will see white and red portions, chamber portions, how there is a, and there is a more and more portions that is heart, the whiteness is increasing. So there is some of this, if you say normal heart and a infected heart also, there is affecting some of that things. So, and some of the white masses also coming. So these are the some of these clinical changes due to columnaris disease. Again, some photo I have seen, I have shown you only one photo there here for the columnaris in the smaller form, but you will see other factors how the columnaris disease is spreading from fish to fish, from one place to another place also. So this is a clear-cut indications that the disease pattern, if you so look into the fish, so and if you go to the farm side and frequent netting and harvesting of these things, you can have a good knowledge about the disease occurring pattern in these systems. So this is a briefly of the general bacterial diseases that are encountered in Indian conditions in fish. Again, if you see some of this, like your shellfish bacterial disease, you know that is in shrimp, that is a early mortality syndrome, EMS. EMS is a major problem in the nowadays in the Vanam industry also. So EMS, because of that, is a Vibrio paramyleticus, one strain is there that is mostly responsible. Then you will find in freshwater, if you see in the summer, early part or late part of the summer, when water depth is coming down, you will find there is a black spot on the exoskeletons. Black spot on the exoskeletons. And that is, if you take a swab and go for the culture practices, you can find some of the Vibrio group also associated in the freshwater plant. So that is a, mostly these are the, and besides, because these are the emerging diseases I am talking, besides that, I told in the shellfish, Vibrio, all group of Vibrio, like Vibrio alginolyticus, Vibrio paramyleticus, Vibrio harbi, that is called luminescent Vibrio, Vibrio splenditus, Vibrio fluvialis, so many Vibrio groups are responsible, and you will find isolation, maybe both are, maybe there are two types of colony in Vibrio, they are found, one is your yellow colony, another is a green colony. So therefore, when if anybody go for the in a farmers, load of yellow colony and green colony that are mostly responsible for the culture of these practices. So these are the, in general, if you'll find there is a Vibrio infections, and for the general, if you'll see, maybe for these types, mostly you have to reduction of the space, feeding, you have to change the feeding, or if you exchange the water, or increase the water levels in the pond, that will reduce these bacterial diseases of the shellfishes in the culture conditions. Any doubt till so far? Any doubt?
Students may respond. If you have any doubt, you can ask to.
We'll stop here in bacterial disease. Let us listen any response from the student. Or anything they have there, they saw anything in their last 2 years, anything they have seen, or any farmers have asked anything about the disease or anything. Or my teaching is so much difficult to understand also. Anything?
I have one question, sir.
You can start feeling bored. Bully.
Sir, nowadays, Aeromonas veronoi is also a disastrous disease causing agent. So how can we identify? Is there any way out to, within a first diagnosis, that we can say that whether the infection is due to Aeromonas veronoi or a hydrophila, sir?
You see, for farmer point of view, you see, it is an infection by Aeromonas. Okay.
Yes.
You should know that it's an infection by Aeromonas or a bacterial infection. Farmers do not want that what a particular disease pattern. So it's a bacterial infection that is enough for a farmer. Second thing, for a researcher, you want a publication or other things, stimulating, directing a verum or something else. But you have to see the percentage, how much is coming. If you are going a plate culture assay or antibody systems, because there are aeromonas specific primers in there. If you go to the aeromonas specific primer, then you can go to the aeromonas. Again, if you go to a Veroni, because there is no distinguish, even a colony morphology, if you go, no distinct. Only you PCR based things you have to go, then you can find. Again, we have to see the antigen levels. Today, if you see, because these are all gram negative bacteria, they share a common epitope in ether. If you develop also antibody, then if you go out to the monoclonal antibody, an epitope region binding factors that is required. And in Indian scenario, you see the disease research, money put is very less, and people cannot afford to go in a specific way also. Specific, because establishing this type of things, working with the pathogens, maybe 5-7 years, then you will come out. But generally, we always advise, if a farmer's stock is saved by telling a bacterial disease that is related to aeromonas, because you have to go for antibiotic treatment or a sanitizer which can take care of this thing, because you are not treating individual fish. You are treating an environment. And if you are going the feed, giving antibiotics to the feed, and you are treating to the fish. So there are two strategies you have to understand, and accordingly you have to work. Had it been a viral etiology, then we couldn't have thought of this. The bacterial etiology, we should first see what is the disease pattern and what is the symptoms. Right?
Okay, sir. And sir, another question. Betadine is an ointment, isn't it, sir? That is used for the dermal healing purpose.
No. Are bhai, ointment nahi hai, lotion hai. Ointment aapko nahi bola. Ointment jo nikalta hai, ye aata hai. Lotion ek bottle mein 100 ml se 1 liter bottle tak milta hai.
Achha,
this is Savlon Dettol, hai na?
Yes,
you'll
sir,
get
yes,
betadine in 1 liter also.
Okay.
That way effectively used, because that is a provincial iodine, so that will take care of bacterial infections and other things also.
Okay.
Right? Any student?
Yes, sir, a question hai. Agar kisi pond ka, agar 50% se bhi zyada machli agar disease se aati hai, infection hai, तो उसको इंडिविजुअल हम ट्रीट करेंगे या सिर्फ पॉन्ड में
पॉन्ड को ट्रीटमेंट करना, इंडिविजुअल ट्रीटमेंट करने से आपका ये चला जाएगा, क्योंकि इफ होल्डिंग पहले होल्डिंग आप कैसे मछली को निकालेंगे. सपोज 1 हेक्टर पॉन्ड है आपका, 8000 स्टॉकिंग है, 7000 मछली है, 3500 50% आप बोल रहे हैं 3500 मछली इन्फेक्शन है, आप इंडिविजुअल को कैसे ट्रीटमेंट करेंगे? और इंडिविजुअल ट्रीटमेंट करने से बाकी जो मछली इन्फेक्शन नहीं होगा, कोरोना जैसे कैसे आपको पता चलेगा? तो इसलिए ऑलवेज ट्रीट द एनवायरनमेंट, हम लोग ऑलवेज ट्रीट द एनवायरनमेंट देन ट्रीट द फिश, ये प्रिंसिपल आप पहले याद रखना है. इन एक्वा कल्चर वी शुड ट्रीट द एनवायरनमेंट देन ट्रीट द फिश इफ द इन्फेक्शन रेट इज स्प्रेडिंग. अगेन इफ यू सी द टाइप ऑफ इन्फेक्शंस एंड ड्यूरेशन ऑफ इन्फेक्टिविटी, the infection spread within 2-3 days, large scale mortality, viral etiology. Infection gradually spread, mortality occurred 1 or 2, bacterial etiology. So aapko ye sab dimag mein lena hai, right?
Yes sir, agar koi pond mein agar maan liye surface pe dikh raha hai ki ye machli infected hai to usko kya karna padega?
सरफेस में देख रहा है, सरफेस को क्यों आ रहा है, क्यों आ रहा है, पहले यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाई द फिश इज कमिंग टू द सरफेस. फिश जनरली इंफेक्टेड फिश कम टू द सरफेस व्हेन देयर इज अ लेस ऑक्सीजन उनको ये है. ओके, तो उसको पकड़ के देखिए, उनको गिल को स्टडी करिए, गिल में पैरासाइट है क्या, पैरासाइट होता है तो उनको ऑक्सीजन मींस रेस्पिरेशन में प्रॉब्लम हो रहा है इसलिए सरफेस आ रहा है. और उसके ऊपर वुंड है कि नहीं, वुंड है तो ऑक्सीजन गिल सही है, वुंड नहीं है, वुंड है तो देयर इज सम बैक्टीरियल इन्फेक्शन, मैं भी स्टेज 3 में हो गया और 1-2 स्टेज में वो मर जाएगा, तो इसीलिए आपको सैंपल नेटिंग करना पड़ेगा. because that you don't concentrate over that fish, you have to concentrate over the pond fish. वो मछली को आप individually आप हापा में कर सकते हैं treatment के बाद में glass jar में कर सकते हैं. और वो fish की use करके what is the causative organism आपको define करना पड़ेगा. But simultaneously we have to do a netting operation. आपको एक netting करके मछली को देखना है कौन सा मछली कैसे infection है, infection ज़्यादा बढ़ गया क्या. Then your attention is there, pond health. Then fish health. Then you treat both the things, find that everything is good. Right?
Yes, yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Let us stop here. We'll stop here.
Yes,
right?
Yes, students?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes. Because if I teach more, it will be confusing yes. for you. You will be confused because you are second year. Therefore, I am taking pause and giving total scenario of bacteria, how it is working. I want so that you should understand first. Then maybe next class, we can go to the parasites. Okay. Parasites, fungus, all these things. Right? Okay?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
I, next class, I will ask all of you what you have learned also.
Sir, we have sent this presentation. Sir, you have sent this
presentation. There is no problem. But you have to study. What is the presentation? Where I go, I leave it. Where I go, I leave it. Because I don't have anything. I want to give everything.
But sir, revision ke liye to presentation chahiye na sir.
तो दिखाई देता हूँ इसलिए तो मैं स्क्रीन में दिखाया सब कुछ शेयर किया आप रिकॉर्ड किए होंगे तो भी आ जाएगा
सर रिकॉर्ड मोबाइल में तो नहीं
दिन का मेल में मैं भेज दूंगा ऐसे नहीं ओके
बिकॉज़ थैंक यू सर
आई डिड
वी हैव वीडियो रिकॉर्डिंग सर
हेलो
वी हैव वीडियो ऑफ दिस लेक्चर
Okay.
Yeah, that video recording and that will be we are going to put on our university website.
Okay, okay. No issue. No. Because I didn't prepare yeah. a specific presentation intending. I thought that I can take one things from here, showing the picture and I can describe elaborately to the student. Had it been a student mode, then we have to go for the pathogen's description, how it looks, what is the gram staining. So a lot of things are there. But this, I think if you'll finish this one, if any specific demand for according to your syllabus, then we can, I can call my scientists also. Dr. Behra is also sitting here also. We can tell him we will take something related to molecular biology. If some students you have courses there or some other disease person also.
No sir, actually, they are going through with the fish and shellfish pathology course this time. So they are just going through with the definition about the, like inflammation, necrosis, apoptosis, and all that has to be covered. So I think okay. that whenever you say mycotic granuloma and all, I think they will be unable to understand. So little bit.
Okay, that one will tell something of basic microbiology. Yes, okay, sir. You just tell me pathological symptoms, syndromes. Let me finish this disease pattern.
Yes,
then
sir.
We can go for the terminology.
Yes, sir.
Okay. We can go for the terminology. Definite terminology. What is the inflammation? What is the necrosis? Type of necrosis, pycnosis, karyolysis, karyorexis. How the cellular inflammatory changes takes place. So that way you can go. Okay.
Yes, sir. Thank
or
you, sir.
I can call some of the disease people here. They can take specific class also. Just you just sign yourself. You can give me what are the particular for the students, what particular lectures you want. So you can design also and give the students also.
Okay, okay, sir. But by tomorrow, we will send a list of lectures. Record for
this, yeah, yeah. This lecture, maybe we can continue tomorrow one more day.
That is quite informative for the students.
Yeah, because I give them, because a farmer's point of view, the students with the presentation. Because I always give a pictorial presentation. If I start with the necrosis type, all these things, that will be confused. That is one-to-one mostly.
Yes, sir. This is very nice presentation to understand the changes or the disease pattern that they can learn about, sir. Thank you, sir. Yeah. Thank you very much.
Tomorrow we can continue this one at 11 o'clock, one more, so that I can finish this chapter. Like bacterial, fungal, and viral, these three portions. Then we can go for these specific changes, inflammatory reactions, all these things. Okay.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Right?